David Jason is Inspector Jack Frost.
The cheaper they are, the greedier they are. And greed, my son, is the biggest mistake of the lot.
You're the detective, not I. Which is why I'm surprised you haven't commented on the best bit.
Good God.
A Touch of Frost starts Friday at 9:30 on RTE1.
The Minister for Enterprise and Employment, Rory Quinn, has said he's optimistic a formula can be found to break the deadlock in the Team Aer Lingus dispute. However, after a meeting with the Congress of Trade Unions, a spokesman for the craft union said they're still insisting on an open agenda for the resumption of talks. There was a separate meeting between the employers' organisation, IBEC, and team management. The RUC say there was a rocket attack on a bar in Belfast city centre shortly before 11 o'clock. Nobody was hurt, but several customers inside Monaghan's pub at the corner of Dock Street and Corporation Street were treated for shock. The Taoiseach and leader of the Labour Party, Dick Spring, has said there won't be a formal voting pact with Fianna Fáil. After discussing the issue with the Taoiseach, Mr Spring said Labour intends to fight the elections as an independent party. Meanwhile, the elections for a new urban district council in Castlebar, County Mayo, which were to have been held on Thursday, have been postponed following the death of one of the candidates. A Fianna Fáil councillor for 27 years, Mr. Jude Ainsworth, died yesterday after a long illness. The Department of the Environment says a new election will now take place on the 18th of June. However, voting for the Doyle by-election and the European Parliament will go ahead in Castlebar on Thursday. And the weather forecast. Most places will be dry and clear overnight, but there will be a few isolated heavy showers, mainly near Atlantic coasts. Lowest temperatures 4 to 8 Celsius. Tomorrow, the northern half of the country will become overcast, with rain in places, especially in Ulster. Further south, it will be mostly dry, with sunny spells. It will be cool and windy everywhere, with highest temperatures of 12 to 16 Celsius. And that's all tonight from the newsroom.
God, it's time to put away the books and notes. The first exam is in the morning, and I do feel nervous. What if I can't remember anything? What if the questions are awful? So much depends on those few hours in the exam hall. Be with all of us who will find it difficult to sleep tonight. Be with us as we begin our exams tomorrow, and stay with us through the difficult days ahead.
Let's take a brief look ahead now to our menu for tomorrow evening. And we begin with comedy at 7 as Tony Danza stars in Who's the Boss? 30 minutes later, the fictional Sherlock Holmes investigates the facts behind the amazing hoax of the Piltdown Man. Then at 8:05, Dick Van Dyke stars in a somewhat groggy Dr. Sloan on Diagnosis Murder. Part 1 in a new documentary series gets underway following the main evening news. The Great Railway Journeys of the World takes a fascinating look at people who both work and travel on trains. Storyteller and schoolmaster Brian McMahon talks about his remarkable life in Rivers of Words at 10:30. And we round off our evening at 11 with episode 1 of a two-part mini-series telling the story of an undercover agent in the Gestapo during World War II, A Woman at War. And before we take our leave of you for this Tuesday night, let me tell you about some of the programmes to be enjoyed early tomorrow. We begin our day at 11:10 with the first news summary of the day, followed by programming for our younger viewers. Santa Barbara fans can catch their favourite soap then at 11:25. And then the final programme, The Passion for Angling, gets underway just after midday. And our Wednesday matinee at 4:05 stars Orson Welles in the historical romp Black Magic. Well, we hope you've enjoyed your viewing this evening, and maybe you'll tune in at some stage tomorrow. Until then, from everyone here in RTE1, from our director tonight, Catherine Scott, and myself, Marion Kramer, have a restful night now. Good night. The time is 33 minutes past midnight. Get the imagine more of Gwyn Oishla, Ihiwahif.
Just remember till you're home again, you belong to me.
Radio One. I would stop the war. That was our own Suzanne Murphy, I Will Walk With My Love, and that's a track from her album There Is an Isle, her most recent album, and I'm sure a big selling album too. Now, another anniversary I just noticed, this news to me, in 1929, the Papal State, which had not existed since 1870, was revived, and the Vatican City was established in Rome. Of course, I would have thought it was there for years before that, but there you are, only there since 1929. Now, we have time for just one more record from Dino. Isn't that too bad? I hope you liked that version of You Belong to Me there. It's one you don't too often hear. And what will the last one be? Well, it's kind of toss up, there are loads of them there, but I think I will plump for this one, which was actually a hit from was number two in 1958. It's a little of the old mother tongue in it as well. So, last one for tonight. I hope you like this one from Dino. Lovely, wasn't it? I hope you like that. That was Dean Martin, Return to Me. Dino Paul Crocetti, born on this day in 1917. So there he is, celebrating his 77th birthday. I hope he is happy and enjoying it, because he has brought certainly a lot of happiness to a lot of people, and plenty of them I know in this country too. Now it's time for Matins with Father Morgan Costello.
I saw the young smoker coming towards me in her school uniform, the cigarette held proudly aloft. She puffed out the smoke with exaggeration and tapped the ash firmly onto the pavement. It was a statement, Lord. I am grown up. I am free. Free from the dictates of parents and teachers, free from the rules of home and school, free to express myself as I wish. And I thought, Lord, of 10 years' time, when she'll be addicted to nicotine drug, on 20 or 30 a day, no longer free. Lord, all our young people are very dear to you. Direct their idealism to a positive, creative future. Teach them that real freedom must be governed by your law. May they never use their freedom to become enslaved.
And now from Val, good night. The time is 12:15.
Radio 1 News with Michael Murphy. The Minister for Enterprise and Employment, Rory Quinn, has said he's optimistic a formula can be found to break the deadlock in the Team Aer Lingus dispute. However, after a meeting with the Congress of Trade Unions, a spokesman for the craft union said they're still insisting on an open agenda for the resumption of talks. There was a separate meeting between the employers' organisation, IBEC, and team management. Meanwhile, a group of team workers staged a protest yesterday evening at a Dublin hotel used as a base by the Aer Lingus chairman, Bernie Cahill. Mr. Cahill wasn't in the hotel at the time. The RUC say there has been an explosion in Belfast near the city centre. Police say the blast happened shortly before 11 o'clock at the corner of Dock Street and Corporation Street. There are no reports of injuries, but several customers at a public house in the area are believed to have been treated for shock. It's not yet clear what caused the explosion. The area has been sealed off, and British Army experts are examining the scene. The Taoiseach and leader of the Labour Party, Dick Spring, has said there won't be a formal voting pact with Fianna Fáil in Thursday's European election and the by-election.